All right, wonderful people, welcome back to this wonderful channel where we bring you back-to-back updates and information. If this is your first time of joining us on this wonderful channel, kindly go ahead and subscribe, like, comment, share, and also remember to on your notification button so that whenever our news drop, it will be the first. We'll collect them. All right, let's go down to the news proper as it is hot. You don't share as it be, the men of the energy, them boys don't collect what they call water promise. I hear say the clash, no be small clash. How the thing take happen, now for one of the empire of the Biafra land, where the baby say them boys, then they deploy them. You know, say some young boys, our people say that no yes bu onye buma duzo sibeni. No na ki e won pon paya e wota go onye bu madu zo sibenu igbokwenu ya igbokwenu ya igbokwenu ya igbokwezuenu ye ma su chapun kan igbo ufodun de na sim na this channel na na su English when I see you in the China or when I force first brother of China kon de buy na general China o gem one or China I buy okwo na o following the buy na Germany, je go German language. Even self emechara o to adan one them onwatara scholarship from federal government gagwa Romanian language. What I go now? It's good to learn new languages, but for us ndi Igbo, before I continue with what I'm saying, we need to be proud of our own language. Because if you see what is happening now, some people now mumwas in America. London, so many places, you see, there some of them encourage their children not to, you know, adopt to their local language. And your local language is who you are. Yes, I'm an advocate of education. I believe that every single person should be educated, you know, be versatile in wisdom. You know, you can engage yourself in a lot of languages, but don't forget about your own. You keep it to yourself, and that is how you pass your cultural heritage over to your children. Those days when we were in school, they told us about a formal and informal education. You see about things written down and things that can be passed down to, you know, to a generation through, you know, eye contact, through, you know, normal relating with them, growing up together. I see those cultures being passed down to those people, and that is how it is. So I encourage Ndi Igbo Bikonu, in order to, even as much as Ndi Igbo wants to a nation, I know that Ndi Igbo, wherever they are, wants a nation. You might not, it might not be, it might not come in a platter of gold. Those who are in politics might not open up to say it, but the people who are the real Ndi Igbo, Ndi Gago Oluga Igbo, you know, there are Ndi Igbo now. If you go to places like America, you see a lot of Ndi Igbo that are engaging themselves in many things. I'm telling you, even in America now, Ndi Igbo now are like the Jews those days in Germany when Adolf Hitler got angry and decided to eliminate all the Jews. That is how Ndi Igbo are now in different countries of the world. You go to Canada, you see them. You go to Saudi Arabia, you see them. You go to America, you see them well-educated, well-developed, and the rest of them. Our doctors are working in different countries, and most of these doctors are Ndi Igbos. Go and ask questions. Go and verify and know who these people are. Meanwhile, as it is, let's go back to the information of the day. As it be, you get one information where we say a day for my table. They say senior Vatican official make case for a marital priest, a married priesthood. Hey, don't shell. Of course, you know, say some people they tell me, say, why I carry him out, they put for church matter. Somebody comment them. I mean, one reply to that comment, I say, I go talking generally. People did not understand what is church and what is fellowship and what is organization. What differentiates church from every other organization is God Himself, because people go there to worship the Almighty God. And now, it is not that they did not tell you to go to church without your brain, without your sense. You have to be reasonable. You have to reason everything. You don't have to see a human being like you as a God. You respect the Pope, yes, but if Pope says what is not according to the
the canonical orders. That is what is called the canonical orders. Those canonical orders are what Christians are following. If we are talking about Christianity, let's look at it from that angle now. Even that, if a pope is saying what is out of the canonical orders, the pope should also be brought back to what is the beginning of everything. Because even the church came together, there was an agreement, so many agreements with the church, where the church came together and agreed that there is what is called the God the Father, God the Son, and the God the Holy Spirit. It was about the church came together and agreed about the Trinity. And the general kuku ibu bolonwa Anglican, bolonwa Catholic, eho okukwe nke ndi ozi. Because all the churches in this world, as new Pentecostal churches, many of them emanate from Anglican, especially Anglican and Catholic. You see the Methodists, you see the Orthodox Church. These are where these are more like the foundation. And there are other things that have been there. Meanwhile, make I carry you go for waiting. They happen now. They stop for church. I just want to make you see this one. But I go like you be person where you say you get open heart to learn. Make you no go they come. They say they talk about church. Just now information now with the past and all of us. Nobody is above information. And now why good day for this channel. They say Vatican City, January 18th, Reuters, Roman Catholic Church should seriously think about allowing priests to marry. A senior Vatican official and advisor to Pope Francis said in an interview published on Sunday, "This is probably the first time I am saying it publicly, and it will sound heretical to some people." Archbishop Charles Sisuluna of Malta, who is also adjunct secretary in the Vatican Doctrinal Office, told the Times of Malta. Pope Francis in 2019 ruled out any chance that he would change the Roman Catholic rule requiring priests to be celibate. But it is not a formal doctrine of the church, and so it could be changed by a future pope. In an interview with a Latin American news outlet in 2023, Francis spoke about the celibacy rule again, saying that it is not eternal, like priestly ordination, but a discipline that could be revised. A Vatican spokesman did not respond to a request for comment. Siluna, perhaps best known for his investigation of sexual abuse crime, noted that priests were allowed to marry in the first millennium of the church history and that marriage is allowed today in the Eastern Rite of the Catholic Church. "If it were up to me, I would revise the requirement that priests have to be celibate," he said. "Experience has shown me that this is something we need to seriously think about." Siluna, 64, said the church had lost many great priests because they chose marriage. He said there is a place for celibacy in the church, but it also had to take into consideration that a priest sometimes falls in love. He then has to choose between her and the priesthood, and some priests cope with that by secretly engaging in sentimental relationships. The debate over whether Roman Catholic priests should be allowed to marriage has been around for centuries. Married men are allowed to become priests in the Eastern Rite of the Catholic Church as well as in the Orthodox Church. Protestant and Anglican churches also allow a married priesthood. Opponent of marriage priesthood is the Roman Catholic Church, say celibacy allows a priest to dedicate himself entirely to the church. In 2021, the Pope dismissed a proposal to allow some elderly married men to be ordained in remote areas in the Amazon, where some places the faithful saw priests as little as 1 year. My people, when I don't see as it happen, wait till they carry put for this matter. Catholic Church don't they suggest say make priests them they marry, and the Pope they say no, that one no follow, and they look at that doctrine, they say that one no be church doctrine, and just doctrine will be say Catholic Church themselves adapt, and they say that it is capable of being changed, and Siluka, 64 years old, Archbishop, is requesting and also writing to the Pope to allow priests to get into marriage if they want. And according to him, he said that Catholic Church has lost a lot of priests due to the issue of celibacy, that sometimes someone can fall in love, that priests sometimes do fall in love. And because of this, it makes them sometimes to engage in secret scandal, sexual activities. And that have been the issue everywhere in Africa, in the West Africa, in the Northeast, and everywhere in the Rome and the rest of them. I think, in my opinion, I think the Catholic Church should look into this. Imagine how many people we have lost their lineage due to priesthood. Even though some of them go secretly to make children, but you could imagine the species we have lost all this while. So I think, for me, I think the Catholic Church should look into that, because even in the Anglican Church, it is not a taboo, it is not anathema, it is not an omen. Even in the Anglican Church and other Orthodox churches, they encourage you to marry before you go into priesthood. And it is only Catholic Church that has been against that. But according to them, they say that that is only a doctrine for the Catholic Church, that it is open to changes. And the Pope has the final say, and everybody is still looking at it. For me, I think some other things should be also be allowed to be looked into, that church should be an open affair where nobody will, someone will have a final say, but it will not be dependent on one person, where a final say should be on a debate based on what is written according to the scriptures. If you have any comments, just drop it. Of course, you know, saying that me and you still there, don't touch that dial. And if this is your first time of joining us on this wonderful channel, kindly go ahead and subscribe, like, comment, share, and also remember to on your notification button so that whenever our news they drop, bang, bah, you'll be the first. We'll collect them. Thank you for listening. God bless you.